Assalamu alaikum, brothers and sisters. I hope you are well. 27-year-old Sheikh Mohammed Mutumba, an Imam from Uganda, thought he was marrying a woman called Swabullah Nabukeera, where they wed in a traditional Islamic ceremony in December. Mutumba got suspended from his duties as a cleric at the Kyampisi Masjid Noor Mosque, while an investigation found out that his newly wedded wife was arrested for stealing a neighbor's television set. Her true identity was exposed when a female police officer carried out a body search on the suspect, thinking she was a woman, and found out she was actually a man. The Imam claimed he hadn't been intimate with his wife since the wedding 2 weeks before because she told him she was menstruating. Friends and colleagues said they were also fooled by the imposter, who usually wore a hijab. Emisi Kibunga, who also works at the mosque, said he had a sweet voice and walked like a woman. Kibunga also revealed that Mutumba had complained 4 days after the wedding that his new bride refused to undress while they slept. Local Muslim official Sheikh Abdul Noor Kakande said that the unfortunate incident was being investigated. Mosque officials said they suspended the Imam despite confirming he had entered the marriage thinking Nabukeera was a woman. The mosque head Imam Sheikh Isa Busulwa said suspension was necessary to preserve the integrity of their faith. He said Mutumba had worked at the mosque for 4 years and he was one of its 3 imams. The thief later admitted pretending to be a woman so he could marry the Imam and steal his money. Subhanallah. Brothers and sisters, I'm sure this isn't the first case about a deceptive marriage you have heard of. Today, we live in a world where people are not trustworthy. Humanity is diminishing day by day and people are craving wealth, luxurious lifestyle and popularity. Matrimonial frauds are increasing, where people are marrying only for the wealth of other party. Brothers and sisters, it is necessary for us to go through a background check for the party whenever someone wants to marry. It is necessary to check the history of the person whom you want to marry, as it is a matter of a lifetime commitment. Doing so, it will provide for you to be confident about the spouse you'll marry. We are forgetting that this life is only a test from Allah, and whatever riches one might have in his life will be left behind when he dies. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us all with the capacity to understand the truth accurately, a good spouse and a healthy life. Ameen. Until next time, Assalamu alaikum.